Today we'll be learning about MPU6050 Gyro Accelerometer Sensor. This is a sensor that is used for controlling the tilt detection as well as roll, pitch and angle. So these are the pinout of MPU6050. It has 8 pins from INT, AD0, XCL, XDA, SDA, SCL, ground and VCC. Out of these 8 pins, we will be only using 4 pins. They are VCC, ground, SCL and SDA. So these are the pin functions. The VCC is used for supplying power and GND for ground. SCL is a serial crux and SDA is serial data. So you can see this is the pitch, roll and yaw indication. Means the rotation in 3 different directions, that is X axis, Y axis and the Z axis. This is sensor is used in aeroplane for controlling the motion of aeroplane. So this is all about the gyroscope axis. So it has X axis, Y axis and Z axis that will be controlling the rotation of roll, pitch and yaw. Now similarly, this MPU6050 contains accelerometer as well. Now this accelerometer is used for measuring the gravity by tilting, that is via X axis, Y axis and Z axis. So you can see the angle is phi and the angle is psi. It has positive, negative axis. So these are the connection diagram for controlling the speed of a motor using MPU6050. So these are the MPU6050 sensor. We are using SCL and SDA pin of MPU6050 to Arduino F4 and F5, which are the SDA and SCL pin. Similarly, we are using L290D motor driver IC for interfacing the motor with Arduino Uno board. D3, D2, D5 and D4 are used for giving the input to L290D motor driver IC. We are using total 5 volt circuit. This is a practical indication. So you can see I have used Arduino Uno board. This is 16x2 LCD for displaying. This is MPU6050 Gyro accelerometer sensor. We are only using 4 pins. This is L290D motor driver IC for controlling 2 different motors. And this is the motor 2. I don't have propeller, that's why I have used a long wire for indication. And this is motor 1, M1 and M2. So I will be giving the power supply. Whenever I will give the power supply, initially it will display initializing. After getting connected to MPU6050, the motor will start turning. So initially it is at level position, so the speed will be equal. Now when you rotate it in X and Y axis, the variation will be seen in the speed. So I have rotated, so you can see the speed of motor 2 has raised and the speed of motor 1 is still low. Now I'll do the opposite bending, sorry, the opposite turn. So you can see the speed of motor 1 has raised now and the speed of motor 2 has decreased. Now tilting on the left and right direction will do nothing because the coordinate of each is not used, it is only used roll. So you can see the speed is low. In case of other motor, the speed is high. This is controlled by the tilting position. Now it is at level position. So the both motor will have almost equal number of speed. Now I'll again tilt this one for controlling the speed again. So again it is checked and now you can see the speed of motor 1 rising higher and higher. So I will be now explaining you about the program. So this is the header file. for MPU6050. So for the header file, I have uploaded it on my website. So this is my website, lifeisprettyhuge.com. That is, life is pretty huge electronics. I have posted all about the details about the videos here. So this is the whole explanation. You can visit. These are the connections and these are the program. So you can see I have updated the library. So download the library file from here. After downloading the library file, go to the sketch, click on 8.zip library, we are doing this for adding the zip files. Now select the location where you have downloaded the library file. So now select the library file and click open. So library successfully uploaded. So these are the header files for MPU6050. This is for LCD interfacing. We are using digital pin 2345 of Arduino for controlling the motor. And this is the program that is related to header file. So I will not be explaining about the program because you will be finding the program description in the link below. That will explain all about the program. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for more videos, and if you have any doubt, please comment down.